What up, YouTube? Your boy Mustard is back with another banger, and as you can see the title, we're going to talk about the Pistons. And usually when I talk about these small market teams, they don't really get a lot of views and they don't get a lot of likes. So if you are a fan of me and you want to see me continue to succeed on YouTube, drop a like right now, because the likes, I know they're not going to be too high because nobody really cares about the Pistons until now with Cade Cunningham on the team, which we'll get into in a second. Also, subscribe to my second channel. I reacted to all the free agency news, and I will continue to react to the free agency news on that channel. And I reacted to Lonzo going to my squad, the Chicago Bulls. But enough of all the plugs. Let's talk about the Pistons, right? The Pistons got the first overall pick in Cade Cunningham. Now, when I look at this Pistons team, they're way better than a lot of people think. Yes, I know they were in the lottery for a reason. Yes, I know they had the first pick for a reason. But there's this thing in the NBA, I don't know if you know what it is, but it's called tanking. And the Pistons obviously were doing that last season. But in the middle of them tanking, they got a whole bunch of young players that have some promise and potential. And adding Cade into the mix, I think will do wonders for this squad next season. And I think they're going to be better than a lot of you guys think. Yes, do not sleep on the Pistons in 2021. But let's start off with the first young player I want to talk about, and that is Sadiq Bey. Now, Sadiq Bey is easily the best three-point shooting rookie of last year. And that says a lot because Sadiq Bey was on fire from behind the arc. And for the 19th pick in the NBA draft, that's fairly impressive. And if he just remains a good shooter for the rest of his career, that's a dub not only for the Pistons, but for his career, because we just saw Duncan Robinson get $90 million all because he can only shoot. And Sadiq Bey has more potential to get better in his career, as though he is 21 years old, he's still only in his sophomore season going into next year. And to put it into perspective how good of a shooter he was, in the last 22 games, he shot 39% from three on over 8 attempts. That is insane. There are whole NBA players in their primes that wish to shoot that kind of a percentage. And to add on top of that, in those last 22 games, he also averaged 16 points along with 6 rebounds and 2 assists. Yes, he did shoot around 41% from the field, but for starters, he is a rookie, so that percentage is to be expected, especially on a team like Detroit. And considering that he's shooting 80% from the free throw line and the three-point percentage that I mentioned earlier, it kind of puts that 41% from the field into a bit better perspective. And adding a guy like Cade Cunningham and Killian Hayes, who missed a good portion of the season, which we'll get to him in a bit, onto the team next year, he's going to be getting a lot more open looks, and I definitely think that those percentages will be going up. The only issues I really have with Sadiq Bey are on the defensive end, as he does have a ways for improvement. I'm not saying he's a liability, but he definitely can get better. And also when it comes to him imposing his will in the post, I definitely would like to see him use his size a little bit more, because the three-point shooting is great, don't get me wrong, but you're 6'7 and you weigh almost 220, 225 pounds. And because of that, I would definitely like to see him impose himself a little bit more on opposing players. But let's move on to the next young player on this team, and that's Killian Hayes, because Killian Hayes, I think a lot of people forgot about him because he missed a good part of his rookie season last year due to an injury. And when he played, yeah, it wasn't the most impressive games of basketball, I will admit. But as far as it pertains to Killian Hayes, he is a project. I was saying that coming into his rookie season, I wrote an article about it. Killian Hayes is a project player. Everyone who watched him overseas and watched him even in his time in Detroit, the limited time I should say, everybody knew that it was going to take about a year or two for him to get acclimated into the NBA, and him suffering an injury did not help matters whatsoever. And to be honest, when I watched him play, his playmaking and vision is really all I needed to see, because he definitely has a high basketball IQ and can make the right decisions, whether it's on the fast break or in the half court. And I think having a guy like Sadiq Bey, as well as Kelly Olynyk, who is a stretch four that they added recently in free agency, they're going to be getting a lot of shots on the perimeter to be able to free up the paint for a guy like Killian Hayes. And I still have faith that my boy will blossom into a top point guard in this league. But another guy that I want to talk about is Isaiah Stewart. Now, when you have a guy like Killian Hayes, you have a guy like Sadiq Bey, both of them are good players, don't get me wrong, but you need a force down low, a guy that can hold his own offensively, whether it's by being a lob threat or in the pick and roll scenario, but can also defend the rim. Who is that guy? Obviously, it's Isaiah Stewart, because Isaiah Stewart, I think, has potential to be one of the better defensive bigs, not only on that team, but in the NBA. Honestly, I think he can be a great rim protector for this team. And considering that last year, he definitely started catching steam when it came to his scoring and his defensive ability, primarily towards the end of the season when he got more starters minutes, I definitely believe that next year, paired with a guy like Sadiq Bey, who's going to free up space for him down low, and also paired with a guy like Killian Hayes, who has great court vision, as well as Cade Cunningham, who trust me, we will get to later. He also has great vision in passing. I think that Isaiah Stewart will have a great sophomore season. And speaking of having great seasons, how could I leave out the veteran? Because when you have a group of young guys, you always want to have that one vet that can help them, whether it's in the locker room, on the court, pacing them. And it's obvious that that guy is Mason Plumlee. Mason Plumlee is a nice little vet, don't get me wrong. He definitely had a solid season with the Pistons, but I'm talking about my boy Jeremy Grant. Jeremy Grant last year was officially a 20 point per game scorer. Not on the best shooting splits, I'll admit, 42% from the field, 35% from three, but considering that he's really the only source of consistent offense on that team, I would say those numbers aren't as inefficient as they seem. And when I watched Jeremy Grant last year, his defensive productivity did go down a little bit, but considering the fact that he took on more of a role in the offense, it's really no shocker that his defensive productivity dipped a little bit. But considering that this upcoming season, he won't have the ball in his hands as much, as they've added another ball handler who was the first overall pick in Cade Cunningham, and Killian Hayes will have another season under his belt healthy, I assume. I definitely think that Jeremy Grant's productivity on the defensive end will aid this team, especially in the front court alongside Isaiah Stewart. So sure, he may not be a 20 point per game scorer, but expect him to average around 15 to 17 points while maybe even making an all defensive team. Because let's not forget the defense that he was playing on guys like LeBron James and Kawhi Leonard in the bubble just a couple of years ago with the Denver Nuggets. And his impact was so noticeable on that side of the ball that when he left, they had to find a replacement in Aaron Gordon via trade. And even if the Pistons want to trade Jeremy Grant and move him for more assets, I have no issue with that, because as much as I would like for him to be the veteran on this team, he definitely has some usefulness. I do believe that if you can move him for a first round pick or another young asset, then you do so. It's not like he's on the timeline of all these other guys, and I'm sure Jeremy Grant does want to win. But that then brings us to the one and only Cade Cunningham, the first overall pick in the 2021 NBA draft. What are Young Mustard's thoughts on him? And guys, I'm super high on my boy Cade Cunningham, because watching him at Oklahoma State, he really has all the tools to be a successful player in this league. And I'm not just talking about a casual all-star here and there. No, I'm talking about an elite all-NBA player. He's 6'8" at the point guard position. That already is a dub, as it presents a whole bunch of flexibility in certain lineups that you want to have Cade in. Because in this era of versatility all over the place with guys like Luka, LeBron, and Giannis, and KD, Ben Simmons, the list really goes on and on of all the versatile players that you have in this league, and Cade Cunningham fits that bill perfectly. Combine that with his great court vision, his ability to shoot the ball from behind the arc, finish at the basket, and some defensive potential as well, the sky really is the limit for Cade Cunningham. I mean, there are GMs saying that he has Luka potential and he could be just as impactful as him coming into the NBA. And if that's to be believed, with the roster that he has, with guys like Isaiah Stewart, Killian Hayes in the backcourt with him, also having Sadiq Bey, a knockdown shooter, Jeremy Grant, who was a 20 point per game scorer last year, Mason Plumlee, who's a proven veteran, I don't see how this team can at least not be competitive in a Eastern Conference. I mean, if the Charlotte Hornets last year were in position to make the playoffs before LaMelo Ball got hurt and still were just a couple of play-in games away from doing so, then I definitely think that it isn't far-fetched to think that the Pistons could do the exact same thing, especially if it is to be believed that Cade is going to be this generational talent that's going to have impact right away in the NBA. So in conclusion, as it pertains to the Detroit Pistons, do not sleep on them in 2021. They have a lot of solid young players that fit perfectly together, and adding a guy like Cade Cunningham to the mix that's going to have impact right away, I definitely think this team is going to be a sleeper team, not only in the Eastern Conference next year, but in the NBA. But A, those are just my opinions and my thoughts on the Pistons. You guys let me know your opinions down below, and I'll respond to as many people as possible. And if you enjoyed this content, like I said earlier, feel free to drop a like on this video, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell for post notifications, as well as check out my second channel called If I Must. That concludes this video, you guys. Y'all stay safe and have a blessed day. Peace.